still here. It's just we went a little long on that recording. I thought I did. So, like I've said so many times, I try to keep it to 15 minutes. I know that most YouTube shorts are 30 minutes and stuff like that, but I try to keep them down to 15 minutes. I'm gonna get the Filmora Wonder video. I used it to make a little intro clip. Now, I thought it would watermark it and it'd be kind of small, or it would kind of flash in and out kind of things, because you can make fucking 4-hour movies on that. No, it just puts in a big-ass bar all the way across, so that's a little annoying. Gamecaster, they just slapped their logo in the corner. Most other people grab a logo, slap it in the corner. What Filmora did, it's kind of annoying. Kind of wish they'd just put it off to the side or something instead of a whole ribbon bar across their screen. But what I saw of them, what I messed with, very easy to use. Real simple. Like 3 or 4 step tutorial to tell you how to start, and then from there it just pretty much says play around, and it does not take long to figure out a lot of that. So yeah, I'm probably going to get that for my editing. It's going to be a little
while. Looks like a new day is dawning.
But once we get that and we can start doing the edited videos, yeah, I'll try and stream couple hours, get my videos, and then I'll edit them together and turn them into like a probably an hour long thing where I've cut down say 4 hours worth of stuff. But I'm also gonna make 2 separate playlists kind of deal, one uncut and one edited. That way you can either watch the highlights or you can watch the whole thing, not miss out. Now, I'm always going to put a little extra in the unedited. Like, if I cut to make time, I might cut out something. Just so the streamers get, everybody who watches the whole thing, get a little extra. That's why I try to keep my videos short. I mean, even when I do that editing, I'm still going to stop the recordings every 15 minutes or so-ish to try and make it easier. Because, oh shit, I was about to flip shit. I thought that was the bear standing there. I was about to get really pissed. Alright. Anyhow, we're almost there. I guess I got one spot right here that I can map. Deer. I still haven't killed one of those. Anyhow, I've been up there busting my ankles like 15 times sliding around on that. Alright, we'll come all the way down to here past the car. We'll map once because I think this is one of the spots that it named that I hadn't had. Sorry, sore throat and everything. I've had a rough time of it all day. Alright. Commuter's Lament. Okay, is this one of the name spots that I didn't get? Nope. I should have had that. Alright, actually, how much of the map is explored now? It still says there's something up here.
Fingers feel numb.
And it says Rabbit Grove, like there's something over in here somewhere. That was one of the things. But it looks like there should be a whole another section of map right there. It's just asshole-ish. Fucked. here, and we'll get to the house. Now, I really don't think that I have mapped anything over here yet.
Hey, I'm so cold.
Apparently I have. Alright. Let's get up here to the houses. Wind's kicking in, my pants are thrashed. That's why I always bring a little bit of extra cloth with me just in case. So if I need to, I can stop somewhere to fix it. Did you hear that thing? Sound like it ran past, but there was nothing there. A little bit of water, a little bit of food, and nothing else. All right. Now, we're gonna fix our pants. Sure, I'd already searched these cars. Yeah, I'd already searched them. see how far we can get with the map. It's a little steep, but we're good. Now, I saw this and I thought, man, that'd be a cool spot to get up and probably get a couple of screenshots kind of thing. I don't know if there's actually a way to get up over there. But there's trees up there, so that would put branches and stuff. And I can clearly tell you that is not a way up. But maybe you can rock climb this a little bit. Oh, looks like I just got a new follower. Captain Curly Fry. Alright. So you made it to the stream, bud. Give you a big shout out. I worked with him. Cool dude. He'll probably be in and out. But thanks for the follow, man. That really helps out. Alright, let's see what we can find over here. Because I couldn't climb up it. Took care of everything that was left over there. So we'll head off to this side and see what we can get over there. I wonder if you can get to the top of that from anywhere. That would be pretty cool. Now, Desolation Point. Hibernia, the Ryken, and the Lighthouse. Basically the only places I ever go. And then from those three, I'll head up to the Stone Church every now and then and come back. And then I typically kind of just stay in the Kwanzaa Hut and don't really explore. But yeah. The first time I actually went looking around on there, we found Katie's secluded corner, and I'll tell you, that's a sweet little spot. I like that. First time I'd ever been, Katie had me a bow and arrow that saved me when I was getting ready to do my forging. And since we haven't been out here to gather up this stuff, chances are we won't be coming back out here. Go ahead and get it while we can. I need some of this. I don't have any antiseptic on me anyways, so I need to grab some of this stuff. Alright, and we're getting close to our next 15, so what we're going to do is stop here in just a second. Go ahead and get this last one. That's 5 pieces. Alright, we're going to pop a squat right there. Right back.